Hi, I'm Tony Velasquez, and this is Future Perfect Tech Shorts. Internet and mobile marketing is growing in the Philippines with the number of internet users at 9 million, or that's about 9% of the total population. Mobile users are at a staggering 35 million, and that's 40% of the population. Just 10 years old, the growth of these media is faster than any traditional media in history. Advertising and marketing play a vital role in the internet and mobile industry, but here in the Philippines, it's still small, with online ad spending estimated at only 100 million pesos last year. That's just 0.2% of total advertising spending. Now, mobile advertising isn't much different. And tonight, I have with me Jose Manuel Fernando, the president of the Internet and Mobile Marketing Association of the Philippines, or the IMAP. IMAP. Oh, some people would like to say IMAP. I say IMAP. JV Rufino, IMAP director. Welcome to the show. Thanks very much for coming.
Good evening, Tony.
Well, we've heard of the digital trends since the IMAP summit last year. Mm-hmm. Are the trends any different for 2012? Manny?
Actually, we've been conducting summit for 6 straight years already. Mm-hmm. And when we started, we've seen the evolution really on how digital's been accepted locally. And last year's message was there's a digital shift.
Right.
And we feel that because of all the activities and the involvement of people in social media and digital, we felt that this year's theme is actually hitting the heart of digital. Because we felt that at the center of digital is really humans and emotions. And that's what we're trying to convey in this conference.
Yeah. Now, what's going to be tackled at the IMAP summit this year as a spin-off from what happened from last year's summit, JV?
Well, we've got some great thought leaders. I think it's the first time CNN is participating in the summit. We also have several speakers lined up. Manny, you perhaps?
Yes. In the previous summits, it's more like the experts coming in. But this year, what we're trying to do is different aspects of marketing. How do they actually utilize digital? So you'll have topics like CSR, shopper marketing. You have e-commerce. You have basically brand experience coming from a client point of view. And we are looking at topics like how do you utilize PR through digital. So it's a very balanced discipline, different marketing discipline going into digital.
Now, from what I've been reading, a lot of digital marketers now see Facebook as the most potent platform. Is that actually true for the Philippine experience?
Well, Facebook is definitely a player in the digital marketing space. I mean, you see a lot of campaigns going on in Facebook right now. It is arguably the social media that comes closest to texting or mobile phones in terms of broad usage.
That makes me a hermit then, because I never really do Facebook that often.
Well,
I do Twitter.
Yeah.
How close is Twitter to Facebook now when it comes to?
I think they're interrelated, but yeah. they have. I think they have very different audiences and different uses. I think my experience is Twitter is more news oriented. People are there for information. Facebook is more of an emotion thing because of the likes. You don't have to respond or say anything. You just like something.
Right.
So.
But you can retweet when you're on Twitter, right?
It's
just a way of liking something.
Yeah, it is. But it isn't necessarily as most people like to say. A retweet is not an endorsement.
It's not an endorsement.
Some journalists will put that on their Twitter account. A retweet is not an endorsement. I mean, letting you know that this is happening, you know. So not quite the same, you know. And I think every bit of social media has its own niche.
Yeah.
In the market, it's
so
an evolving landscape.
Has a better, how do you call it? Chance of reaching your market when it comes to social media.
It's like it's basically like the social media mass market, because it easily has the biggest footprint.
You have 27 million Facebook users locally.
So
it's like 90% of.
I do feel like a hermit then.
It's around 90% of total internet users in the Philippines. So it's really pervasive.
Yeah, I mean, I've people 2-3 times. Actually, the more popular. Most heavy users of Facebook are actually people older than me, you know. So I asked my father why he was so.
And you couldn't be any older than 25, right?
Oh, you know. Okay. Well, I asked one fellow, why? So why are you on Facebook? And he says, oh, I'm on Facebook for one reason. It's the most efficient way to flog pictures of my grandchildren on everyone else.
Okay.
You know.
Now I feel old. Because you know, that's exactly the reason why I should go on Facebook.
Well, some of them are just lurking. Yes, want to check out with friends.
Many are lurking, or many are rediscovering, you know, old high school connections and stuff.
Now, I got to ask you this, because would digital marketing in any way threaten or complement traditional marketing? Because, you know, you're in TV, and we do rely on advertising revenue to survive as an entity. But just how much can you now expect to earn from digital marketing if you are going to see that kind of shift, the digital shift?
Oh, I don't see, you know, if you look at the history of media, no new media ever supplants the other. They all sort of coexist, and people use them for different things. Mm. I've seen there are many campaigns that combine the use of TV and social media, campaigns that combine print internet with social media. Mm. We compartmentalize things, but the consumer is just one experience.
Okay.
And if you're good at weaving it all in, then it's all that much more effective.
I'm kind of curious, though, whether or not with the explosion in you know, the use of smartphones and tablets and everything mobile, right, that people tend to get more content now from the web or online, no? Instead of watching through traditional media like TV or...
But they are watching.
They're still watching.
They're still watching.
It's online live.
They're still reading, you know. It's just that the medium in which it's coming through is different. They may not be watching on a television set, but they're watching online. They're time shifting it.
Yeah.
You know.
Mm. Actually, on my perspective, I've been asked similar questions in the past. Mm. I guess it's all about the context on how you want to utilize it. We've seen, like, for example, there are certain studies that people who watch TV actually are tablet users simultaneously.
Mm-hmm.
So it depends on the purpose what you're doing.
Guilty.
And in other purposes, there's certain engagements that you want to just do it pure digital. But I think it's complementary. It's just that I think there's a changing consumer behavior.
Mm.
So I guess the traditional consumer is a one-way medium, but now it's an interactive medium, and you just have to capitalize on that.
Now, for TV, we have ratings, right? So, you know, actually advertisers check the ratings. Okay, you see which shows are doing better, and they find out which audience is watching these particular shows, so that they get to strategize where to put their ad placements. How does it work for digital marketing? Now that you have an explosion on all of these websites and all of these online promotions.
Well, it's great you brought it up, because one of the initiatives we have in IMAP is precisely a digital measurement, because there are a lot of metrics going around, but we have a group within IMAP that's basically working to create the
joint industry committee. What we've decided is, with IMAP, with PANA, with 4ACE, which is the Association of Advertisers, what we saw was digital media is fairly young.
Mm-hmm.
So the important thing is, what's our starting reference point?
Okay.
So as an industry right now, we're starting to have dialogues and discussions. Say, let's look at a common metric.
Mm-hmm.
So right now, would we say there's one universal metric? There's none. But at least let's start defining some common currency that everybody can discuss with, which is very, very different how you would measure, let's say, a radio, TV, and everything.
Yeah.
So you have to put the foundation.
I always
first.
Hear about clout. Now, are we using that? I mean, is that something
that's one metric one that metric? People take a look at? But there is no one defining metric. Most people take a variety of metrics.
Okay, here or anywhere else?
Anywhere. There's like everyone takes a look to get a sense of things.
Yeah.
And then after a while, you kind of develop a feel.
Okay. Because if I were going to invest my ad budget on digital marketing, I'd actually want to know.
Yes.
Well, I guess the traditional question is, am I reaching the market?
Yes.
Right? How do you track customers, by the way? I mean, How do you know which potential market could be targeted through digital marketing?
Well, that's the beauty of digital marketing is it's possible to go. It's very, very targeted. For example, on Facebook, you can target by everything on their profiles, basically.
Mm-hmm.
Same on Twitter, same on most websites have registration, and also that info feeds in, and then you can track their behavior online.
You can actually track emotions.
Emotions?
You know? Yeah. So is it a positive emotion or a negative emotion?
Yeah, I see. Especially
on
Twitter,
monitor that now.
You have
really?
Tools on Twitter that allow you to tell you these are what people are saying about your brand. Sentiment analysis is actually what it's called.
So how is it triggered? I mean, there are keywords that they're watching out for when you tweet or when you post a message.
Yeah,
that's one way of looking at it. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So and the discussions that are trending. Mm-hmm. So that's another way of looking at the how to measure the effectivity of your company.
Now, is there a downside to digital marketing? Are there any pitfalls that you know, it's in its infancy, you've already learned to sort of go around and not make sure that you don't make any of these mistakes that could turn off potential consumers?
Mm.
You know, well, how intrusive would you be? I mean, all these ads that are popping up
you name one instance where, since it's such a it can be such a targeted thing.
Mm-hmm.
If your message is helpful and relevant,
mm-hmm.
they don't mind.
Okay.
But if it gets in the way or it's irrelevant, then that's when the friction starts.
Mm-hmm.
So
and there's a way to measure that too. I mean, because of the emotion.
Yes, there is a way. You know,
actually, one of the activities that IMAP is doing is like what you mentioned. Where do you set the boundaries,
mm-hmm.
right? And what we're doing right now is we're positioning the medium wherein it has to be consistent also with the best practices and the guidelines of other medium, whether it's TV, radio, and whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So there's consistency that we're trying to do.
Yeah.
Now, is it simple to do? It's not. So we've been doing a lot of discussions, whether it's with DTI, whether mm-hmm. it's with the ad board of the Philippines.
Because there are regulations.
Yes. Yeah.
There are regulations.
Yes.
You're covered by the same regulations.
Yes. And we try to make our own small way to contribute on structuring mm-hmm. the best practices.
Yeah.
And we're doing dialogues with government agencies as well as trade associations.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, IMAP. And you need to do also good PR, right? I mean,
yes.
Good PR, part of the mm-hmm. tools of the digital marketer.
Yep. Yeah. So our purpose is, our association at least, is we want to position us. There's a existing association in the Philippines which are thought leaders
mm.
on the digital space, because
mm.
we're very active. The Philippine market is very active, and that's the reason why we'd like to invite people to go to our internet and mobile marketing summit.
Go ahead.
It's
going to
be on the 23rd and 24th of this month.
Mm-hmm.
It will be done in the Rockwell Power Plant Cinemas 2 and 3.
Okay.
So we'd like to see a lot of people visit us.
Registration still open?
Yes, registration still open. And we have a list of 32 speakers. And it's been growing year in, year out.
Mm-hmm.
So we're very much happy that people are starting to embrace digital now.
Yes. And I should also go on Facebook more. Manny Fernando and JV Rufino from the IMAP, thanks very much for coming to Future Perfect.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Tony.
Coming up, we talk to Jerry Carual about a phone that can withstand extreme weather conditions and a bit of bashing around perfect season for this typhoon time. Stay tuned for that. Welcome back to Future Perfect Tech Shorts.
Now, having a phone that can float as well as withstand extreme conditions is perfect for the type of weather we're now experiencing in the country. The Rug Gear mobile phone does exactly those things, and here to discuss what is described as the Swiss Army knife of mobile communications is Jerry Karuwal, whom I haven't seen in a long time. You're not holding a camera now, you're holding a phone. Okay, your camera's right there. Okay. Jerry, thank you for coming to the show. Rug Gear, sinong gumagawa niyan?
It's a Hong Kong, China-based.
China-based.
But we requested a feature of this, like the radio, the two-way radio. Most of the phone had two-way radio.
Hindi siya. So parang pwede ka rin mag-push to talk.
Yes, push to talk. Meron din siyang GPS, meron siyang GPS navigator, 2-megapixel camera.
Okay.
Touchscreen, dual SIM, quad band.
Sino gumagamit ngayon yan, Jerry, sa alam?
Mostly yung mga kumuha sa amin to, mga nasa rescue.
Rescue,
saka mga firemen.
Services and firemen.
Kasi it can stand yung 55 degrees centigrade.
Nasa
bunker suit nila.
Yeah. Locally, meron na mga gumagamit ng
kami
mga
yung
rescue
teams. Locally, meron marami.
Na ano ba exactly ang katatagan niya? Kasi sinasabi nga natin, pwede siya for all types of weather, di ba? I mean, So, ibig sabihin yan, kung kunwari, ngayon, bumabagyo, di ba?
Yeah.
Lulusong
ka
sa baha. Pwedeng mababad.
Actually, 30 minutes yung kanyang, marirecover mo siya pag nalaglag siya ng 30
minutes. So, may 30 minutes pa?
Meron na, pa. Meron ka pang enough time to recover.
Beyond that, baka pasukin na siya ng tubig.
Baka,
kasi yung moisture, no?
But ang IP, ang ingress protection niya is level 6 and 7.
Meaning?
Sabihin yung dust at saka yung water yung going in.
Gano'ng kalalim, kunwari, pag nahulog?
Hanggang 1 meter to 2 meters.
1 meter deep. So, kaya niya pag malabon, kunwari?
Kaya niya.
Nabotas?
Basta i-dive mo lang ulat.
Lagos nila. Di na niya kaya yun. Seawall. Okay. Anyway, para pakita natin if it still works while it's underwater.
Alright.
Nagdala kami dito ng special water. Special water to.
Okay.
Binindisyonan ko pa. Ha? Para ano, so, ilublog nga natin.
Ito yung akin.
Sa'yo yan. That's what you review.
Kaya lang baka mag-overflow ata.
Ay, hindi. Okay lang yan. Pag mag-overflow, pasisip-sip ko sa floor director natin. So, tawagan mo to, gagana pa siya?
Yeah.
Okay.
Pwede siguro tawagan.
Sige. Tatawagan. Ito yung number mo, bale. Patatawag natin.
It's na silent mode eh.
Silent mode. Sige, just switch it on. Yan.
On ko muna.
Yan.
Nasa silent mode eh.
So may ringtone ba yan, di ba? Pwede ba yung parilan niyo yung ringtone din yan? Ano ba ringtone mo ngayon? Yung Call Me Maybe? Ano ba sa'yo?
Standard ng ano eh.
Standard? Hindi mo pwedeng palitan?
Hindi ko napalitan pa.
Pero customizable ringtone
din. Pwede, MP3.
Sige, okay. Can you call the phone while it's soaked in water? It's the Jerry Karuwal's number. Okay. Okay, anyway.
So, crank din siya, no?
So,
ang charging
anong
niya
battery life niya?
300 standby time. 300 hours standby time.
So, nagre-ring na siya? Nagre-ring na? Can we show it? Okay. Sabi ng ringtone niya, ayun. Ang nakalagay, ABS Assistant Tony. Tama ba yan? So, it's ringing while it's underwater. That's something I will not try with my other phone. So, okay.
Standby time niya is 300 hours, but...
300 hours?
Pag ano siya, pag... yung talk time niya is 10 hours.
Sagutin mo na daw. Nagri-ring ka eh. Palagay ko, ano na to? So, si Mrs. na yan. Sabi, Jerry, bumili ka na ng bawang, sibuyas!
Loudspeak natin siya.
Loudspeaker, pwede rin? Underwater? Sige nga, kasabi mo. Mahina yung volume eh. Sa bagay, mahirap magsalta sa ilalim ng tubig. Anyway, so, baka makalunok ka pa ng tubig eh. So, 300 hours standby time. Pero ano yung hawak mo ngayon?
This is a crank charger siya.
Crank charger. So, kunwari, namatay yung battery mo, wala ka mapagsaksakan ng outlet. How many turns of the crank do you need?
Sa 15 minutes, siguro may 1 bar ka na.
15 minutes, 1 bar. Okay, and 1 bar...
It's charging.
Yeah. Nakikita ba? Can you hold it up? Okay, I'll hold it up. So, pag ganyan, charging siya. Ayan. Ayun, nagsacharge na. Okay.
Kasi GPS ko niya pala.
Okay, sige. So, show that feature too. So, it's a GPS, so you can actually...
locator and navigator.
Yeah.
So it's useful, kunwari, dahil wala na yung mga landmarks mo, di ba? Na nakita mo, lubog na yung mga landmarks, you need to find kung saan mo sasagipin si... Si Christine Reyes, kunwari, di ba? Napasokan ba ng tubig?
Pinapagpagod.
Okay, here's the question. Magkano yung ganyan?
Pwede ko ba on air to?
Of course. Okay. People want to know.
Ang SRP namin is 25,000.
25,000. Yeah. Okay. Isa pa lang yan, isang unit yan. If yes, you buy two or more units, the price goes down? Mayroon pa siya.
So, pag marami na.
Marami.
Okay. Tapos, it can tune to sa ordinary radio. Kasi two-way radio rin siya.
What do you mean you can tune to an ordinary radio?
Yung two-way radio, pwede natin i-channel siya.
Yung frequency. Ah, so pwede mong iset yung frequency?
Pwede iset.
Like, ah, ganun ba? So, kung kunwari yung mga radio dito sa ABS, pwede mong hanapin yung frequency?
Siguro kung ibibigyan ng technician.
Ah, kung ibibigyan ng technician. Yeah. So now, you're communicating with your two-way radio. Okay.
So, pwede siya.
Anong range niya pag as a radio?
Half kilometer.
Okay. Half kilometer?
Ang idea kasi, kaya may radio to, pag na-trap ka during earthquake, no?
Yeah.
Or you're in the basement, so wala kang... Jeep. Cell site, ship to radio ka.
And it will penetrate through, ano?
Ang UHF kasi yung gamit nito eh.
Okay.
So, it penetrates in the walls.
Okay. So, what else does it have? Swiss Army knife, eh, sabi mo. So, it has GPS, it can be a two-way radio.
Torch,
it has a torch. So, may flashlight din siya.
Tapos, alin siya, may 2-megapixel camera.
And a 2-megapixel camera.
Still and video.
Okay, and you need a 2-megapixel camera as a rescuer to document what you're doing.
Yeah. Even yung mga firemen, gamit na nila to. So, very rare na may dalang camera sa loob ng fire.
Yeah. So, mas nagiging ano na siya, parang tool na talaga
it
for rescue.
It can handle 8 gig micro SD. Tapos, sa SOS button sa gitna.
An SOS button?
Yeah. You can program 3 numbers.
Okay.
It's automatically dialed when you...
So, kung kunwari...
na-accidente ka, isa lang.
Yeah. So, you can call a teammate or base
Yeah. Automatically switch to the yung loudspeak.
Uh-huh.
And then you can talk. Tapos can text din to the 3 numbers that you program.
So all with the SOS button.
Yeah.
Send a message to 3
numbers.
And
you can compose the text kung ano yung gusto mo ilagay.
Yeah.
And every minute it can be set kung kailan siya magte-text.
Fantastic. May interest ba ang mga local governments sa device?
A lot of local governments meron na siya.
Okay. So talagang nagagamit na on the field, tested on the field, the rug gear. Ilan bang models yan?
Right now, isa pa lang yung release sa amin. But I think we're coming up with another, meron din kaming floater nito eh.
Floater?
Floater naman sa...
So ito hindi siya nagpo-float?
Hindi siya.
Pwedeng ilubog. Okay, what is the other stuff na nasa tabi
This pala? One, kasi yun nga, short range siya. So, I design naman yung echo box niya.
Okay.
So, this extend yung layo.
Yung range niya?
Yung range
as
niya.
A radio?
Yes,
as a two-way radio.
As a radio.
So, how far does it extend?
It depends kung nakakabit siya, naka-trigger din sa repeater, it can cover all over Metro Manila.
Ah, talaga?
Yeah, basta ma-trigger niya yung repeater. So,
wow.
it is a relay station.
As a relay station, okay. How much does the relay station cost?
Siguro mga 30 or something.
30,000.
More or less, mga 30. This one naman, satellite phone.
Is it also made by Rug Gear?
No. Okay. The problem is, talagang kailangan mo ilagay sa...
Ah, kasi hindi siya waterproof.
Hindi siya katulad
ng Rug Gear. Like that one, okay. So, that's a basic difference. You can't put a satellite phone in your morning coffee. Okay. Jerry Carual, thank you very much for demoing the Rug Gear for us. Sana nga lahat ng mga rescue teams have something like that, no?
It's pretty. Sa ano namin sa foundation, because we have a foundation, Search and Rescue Unit Foundation.
Yeah.
A lot of rescuers talaga ginagamit nila.
All right. Well, fantastic device and pretty timely for all the things that are happening to the Philippines. Jerry Carual, good to see you again. Thank you for coming to Future Perfect.
Thank you.
Next time, kuna mo ulit na to, ha?
Okay.
All right, and that will do it for Future Perfect Tech Shorts. Thank you for joining us. I'm Tony Velasquez. You can join me again next week when we again examine the present and look ahead to the Future Perfect of Philippine science and tech.